The good news is, the very good news is, you may only have one amazing Ralph watch, but you also have one incredible humidor. You,
yes.
You do have, I am told, one of a kind.
There it
humidor.
Is.
Here it is. Wow.
This is made by Daniel Marshall, who's in the room tonight. Daniel, can you stand up, please?
Daniel Marshall, you are the number one humidor designer in the world by the ultimate authority, Cigar Aficionado.
So this, look at this beautiful what? Beautiful box with your humidor. Of course, I was asked to sign it, so I did. And it has the coat of arms, the family coat of arms. It's got some wonderful cigars in it as well. But it is absolutely perfectly equipped with the right instruments to keep the cigars nice and moist and nice at the right temperature.
So, this is incredible, this humidor. And I know already in advance there's only one of it in the world. And as you heard, it is handcrafted by Daniel Marshall, of course, but it is has the personal seal of His Serene Highness. It's embellished with Prince Albert's coat of arms and has been personally signed by His Serene Highness. So, and the good news is it doesn't come empty. It comes with special edition, 92-point rated, red label Churchill cigars, and two 24-carat DM Golden Torpedoes. So, it comes fully loaded. This is the best humidor with the best contents ever, and we will begin this for 25,000 euros. 25,000 euros to start this, 25. At 25,000 euros, any more than 25, 50,000 I have. At 50,000 euros in the fallback of Zoom, I have a bit of 50,000. At 50,000 euros now, I have a bit of 50,000 euros at the very back of Zoom. At 50,000 euros, any more than 50. I have a bit of 50,000 euros. At 50,000 euros in the far back of Zoom, anyone else than 50,000 euros. Unless anyone else is going to bid for it, there is going to be a very, very lucky and happy smoker, cigar smoker. No, but we are at 75, just in time, at 75,000 euros. Up front here, 75, against you the far back, I have a bit of 75. The bid is right here, up front at 75,000 euros, against you the very back at 75. At 75, it's near me, at 75,000 euros. At 75,000 euros, it's your bid, sir. 75, against you in the back, against you in the right. At 75, I will be able to sell it to you, sir, for 75,000 euros. So,
thank you very much.
This is a 1957 Chevy Bel Air convertible in onyx black with a black top and red silver vinyl interior. And yes, it is the V8, which is why it has all of these cool gold accents. And this is comedians in cars getting coffee.
Yeah, buddy.
Hey, this is beautiful.
This is the greatest spot in Chicago.
Oh, this is great.
Steve Harvey, Jerry Seinfeld. That's a pretty good look, man.
Oh, man, you know what I got to do, Jerry? I got to give you one of those Daniel Marshall cigars. It's gold.
I need one. I'm a pimp.
What do you want to be?
I want to be an achiever.
An achiever.
That's what I thought.
And do what I say, no excuses, okay? I need you to get a case of Daniel Marsh's cigars made in the USA. Replace the Dom Targus with those, okay? Go. If you miss him, we'll mail him.
Daniel Marshall. What do you mean if I miss him?
Okay. Run.
If you ask me to go out there and apologize to those pigs, I will stab you in the face.
Oh, forget about the conservatives. I need you to run out. I need you to get me a box of Daniel Marshall cigars as quickly as possible. They're for Arnold.
Do I get to meet him?
I'll introduce you, but you cannot speak. Okay, go. Go.
Yes!
Roman, hey, not only is this against the rules, but you got barbecue sauce on the American flag. You know the rules. What am I going to say?
Don't eat their food.
Okay, that too. So it's three things. So that's triple probation for you.
Daniel Marshall. These real gold cigars, huh? Well, you was at Indonesia? Grassberg Gold Mine or something?
That gold, golden baby. Shining just like a star. Holding a Marshall cigar.
That gold.
Just what we do, 24 karat
gold.
It's just so nice, so right. I'ma need a light.
Cigars,
wait up, ain't that real gold? That real gold. I don't know about you though, or what lie you told. Never had me a cigar that was wrapped up in gold. That's amazing to me, can't believe that shit. How the hell you smoking jewelry? Let me see that quick. Nah man, get your own, this is for the grown. Aw damn, these Marshall cigars are a go. Looking like you got the Midas touch, golden cigar. Looking wavy, put it in the air, golden glass, see it from far.
Light it up, take a toe, go cigars on the joke, on the jet or the boat. Melt it down, make a chain, gold teeth for pinky ring, bracelet, it ain't no thing. Look me up, I am list, just know that I am gifted. We gon' just sell them joints, right in the diamond dish. Take a pull, you ready, hun? No bull, could be very fun. No, your friend can't have none, these not for everyone.
That golden baby, shining just like a star, holding a Marshall cigar.
That gold.
Just what we do, 24 karat
gold.
It's just so nice, so right. I'ma need a light.
Cigars,
wait up, ain't that real gold? That real gold.
Yes.
We smoke the jewelry. You other cigars ain't fooling me. No. I see you, Daniel. About to light up one of these gold things right now. Might go trade my ashes in. You know what I mean? Fuck around, go make a Cuban one in the sun.
I know you.
I want the paper off of it. Just the paper off.
Maybe it's off.
Woo!
what you imagine.
That's beautiful.
That's the most interesting Bible quote. I immediately looked it up. That is fantastic. That says it all.
It protects it all.
Gold leaf. This is that Italian, the German guy I told you about that does that. He's world class. Amazing.
That Bible.
He does the Sistine Chapel repair. They send him all over the world. Yeah.
The weapons formed against me shall prosper.
And there's a few special cigars that you might like in here.
You say you might like your kid. This is what you might like. Oh, you signed it and everything.
So this, you know, we put the water, this
slips
up.
Oh, really?
And then we just pull the.
Oh, that's slick, so you don't see them.
Yeah, so you don't see the humidification.
I got a Daniel Marshall, baby. I got a Daniel Marshall in the collection.
Just the beginning.
That's banging right there.
So, let's see if these are the ones that you fancy.
Ah!
It's in 24K gold. That's top shelf right there. You can hit the ball over the fence with that one. That's it right there.
Only with these here.
That's it right there.
These
are what I'm
wanting. Look at this humidor.
Is banging.
Look at this thing. Let me show it to you.
Hold
tight. Hold tight. Let me show you. Good. I got a Daniel Marshall in the collection.
Der Kitzbühel Country Club war im Rahmen des legendären Hahnenkammrennens auch 2016 wieder Gastgeber seiner besonderen Zigarren-Lounge-Party. Im exklusiven Rahmen trafen sich zu dieser Gelegenheit jede Menge Prominenz, Mitglieder und Freunde des Hauses, um bei der gediegenen Zigarren-Lounge-Party den Skirennsport zu feiern.
Es war wirklich ein sehr, sehr schöner Tag. Man hat wieder gesehen, dass Kitzbühel natürlich eine Plattform ist der Sonderklasse und natürlich der Kitzbühel Country Club ein Herzstück ist und halt die Heimat unserer Mitglieder.
Fernab von überfüllten Partyzelten genossen die internationalen Gäste in der Zigarren-Lounge des Memberclubs die entspannte Atmosphäre mit exklusivem Flair. Feinste Zigarren passen ideal zu Kitzbühel und dem Kitzbühel Country Club, weiß auch der kalifornische Zigarrenexperte Daniel Marshall, der die Zigarren-Lounge gestaltet hat.
It's the incredible location that it's located in this exclusive enclave of Kitzbühel, where it's isolated from the world. I think that it's the quality and the uncompromising way that Richard Hauser and his team constructed this club and this lounge.
Stilvolle Party in exklusiver Atmosphäre und das an einem der angesagtesten Tage im Jahr rund um die Gamsstadt. Davon waren die Gäste begeistert.
Eine Veranstaltung, wo nicht einmal die Leute dich treten und durch die Räume schieben, sondern es ist gemütlich. Aber so für Genießer und Zigarren auch ist es ideal.
Das Besondere ist, dass es ja gar nicht so viele Möglichkeiten gibt, eine gute Zigarre zu rauchen. Und da bietet natürlich unsere Zigarrenlounge in Kitzbühel schon einen ganz besonderen Ort. Und wir haben viele Mitglieder, die das einfach sehr schätzen.
Das ist einmalig, die Atmosphäre. Also heute früh, wie es so geschneit hat, hat man gedacht, um Gottes Willen, das kann ja gar nicht stattfinden. Und dann plötzlich tut sich der Himmel auf und die Sonne kommt sogar raus. Und also es ist eine einmalige Kulisse.
Nach angeregtem Erfahrungsaustausch ging es zum Empfang des deutschen Botschafters in Österreich, Johannes K. Heindl, der den Club als Ehrengast besuchte.
Nach dem heutigen Abend und nachdem, was ich erlebt habe, wie viele Leute hier gekommen sind und was hier an Begegnungen geschaffen worden ist, ganz offensichtlich ist er das schon. Ja, eine Plattform für die Begegnung.
In solchen Namen muss man sich
international, weltweit erstmal erarbeiten.
Ich glaube, so soll es sein, dass man, wie die Engländer sagen, Business and Pleasure perfekt verbindet. Und bin ich dankbar, dass heute dieser Empfang hier stattgefunden hat.
Much for moonlit skies. I never wink back at
firefly. But now that the stars are in your eyes, I'm beginning to see the light. I never went in for afterglow or candlelight on the mistletoe. But now when you turn the lamp down low, I'm beginning to see the light. Used to ramble through the park, shadow boxing in the dark. Then you came and caused a spark. That's a four-alarm fire now. I never made love by lantern shine. I never saw rainbows in my wine. But now that your lips are burning mine, I'm beginning to see the light.
City in the world, in the greatest country in the world, where dreams really can come true. And a good friend of mine.
I am Chichi
Salazar.
Chichi from the movie Scarface. You know, Chichi get the yello. And with Daniel's Gold Cigars, me and him are going to buy the LA Clippers. Okay? Yeah. Yes, we're gonna smoke like Cubans, right?
Absolutely.
Like, you know, no, he makes good cigar. We met at the Scarface reunion, what, a couple years ago?
It was 3 years ago.
Couple years ago, right? Yes, and Daniel is gonna, since we met, I've been writing a movie script called Cuban Sandwich. It's a gangster comedy flick. Cuban Sandwich, and I need a big boy like him to play my bodyguard.
I'm right here.
Yeah. So good luck with the cigar in the Poconos. Oh my God, you guys going to the Poconos?
We're going to the Poconos.
Can oh my God, I lost my virginity in the Poconos.
I hope I find it.
Yeah. Yeah. But this is great, man. Wow.
But thank you for coming by, Angel. That's again only in New York City, where you've got the rock solid friends, and I appreciate you coming by. Celebrating with us, and really,
thank you, Daniel. Thanks a lot. But before you go,
I know you're busy, but before you go, tell me about the story. Tell me about the script. Yeah. Give him 2 minutes to do that.
Oh, 2 minutes? Okay, yeah.
Sit down.
Yeah.
Can you get us in the shot?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So, Angel, I know you're here only for a few minutes because you're off to meet with your manager and your producer.
No. I have to get going because my driver is downstairs. He has ADD. But we'll give it a couple minutes, though.
Well, good, fantastic. So tell me what you're up to, and besides being a world-class actor on the most iconic movie of all time, Scarface, in my opinion, has changed the whole scope of it, not only the movie industry, but also a movie very, very powerful to make us all realize that if we set our minds to it, we can.
Yeah, well, what made the movie famous, like a cult film, more famous than ever, is hip hop artists, you know, rappers like my boy Mero and the kids that do hip hop music, they made it bigger than ever. Because when the movies first came out, it wasn't as big. A couple years, it kept growing and growing. So Scarface became the biggest gangster movie of all time.
American Dream, though.
American Dream.
The American Dream, yeah. Yes, yeah.
And you were brilliant in that film.
Oh, thank you.
So thank you for being here. Thank you for being my friend. And Angel has showed up at some of our great events here in New York City. And he just cannot stop with the comedy, because this guy is a world-class, not only actor, but as I said, comedian. And he is performing all over the country. And I tell you, so tell us about some of your latest work as a comedian and also as an actor.
Yeah, I just wrote a movie script called Cuban Sandwich. It's a comedy gangster flick, sort of like the 1950s, Some Like It Hot, with Tony Curtis and Jack Lemmon. Yeah, it's a story about a comedian, entertainer in Miami during a hurricane in a hotel that end up in the wrong room with a Jewish couple and the Jewish guy end up with this girl. The Jewish girl, not because they want to, it's an accident, a hurricane. So he become a father of a Jewish kid, the Cuban guy, by accident. and the Jewish kid, he's a teenager, come looking for him in Brooklyn, from LA, Fairfax, you know, to Brooklyn, New York. And they borrow money from the mob to do some project, and the mob is after them. So they disguise in all kinds of outfits, like Batman and Robin and all that, to escape from the mob. It's a very funny movie. It's called Cuban Sandwich.
And you know what? It's going to be a big hit.
Oh, thank you.
Can't wait for it to come out. And I'm there behind you in any way I can be. Definitely all the cigars.
Oh, thank you, man.
All the cigars. Every party.
Let me say something. Daniel, a few months ago, the last time he was in New York, he gave me a humidor. Scarface humidor, right? It was white and it says Scarface, and all the actors sign it, right? We sign it?
Yeah.
And I got one of them. Thank you, Danny, for that humidor.
Pleasure. Thank you. I can't do enough for you.
Oh, right now the humidor is waiting for me at the pawn shop.
Well, everything for the dream. You gotta put it all out there, mortgage the house, and loan the humidor to the pawn shop, anything for your dream.
Whatever
it takes to make that movie, it's going to get done.
Thank you, my brother, thank you.
Awesome. So now, can you leave us with a couple jokes? Because you know what? We got it. People got to know. People have to hear you.
It can be blue or clean.
Anything you want.
Okay, I have a big pee-pee. I don't have it with me. Anyway, listen, let's go drink, man. Last time we were hanging out, me and Daniel, we were hanging out with this Amazon from Yugoslavia or Bulgaria, whatever.
Romania.
The smallest one was 6'1". Oh my God. After 5 minutes, my neck was hurting. Yeah, where are those girls?
She had a crush on you.
Yeah, she had a crush on me, yeah.
So what happened?
I don't know, the other girl, your day messed it up. Your day messed it up. Anyway, so we're gonna go have some drink?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, thank you for having me, Danny.
We're gonna drink, we're gonna smoke, yeah. and we're gonna
once again, good luck in the Poconos with that big cigar convention. You know, I'm sure a lot of people, right? 6,000 people?
6,000, man.
Wow.
6,000 men and women. Oh, you know, I'm excited about women coming into the cigar fold, and that's why I think the work that Ray's doing with the musicians and Mello's work and Mello's lyrics, and I think the story of the cigar, and we have top supermodels now smoking the Daniel Marshall cigar in the photo shoots and on their covers, and I really believe that women are going to be very, very important. Women want to feel comfortable smoking cigars, and I tell you, I think they're, because of the story we're telling and how welcoming we are and introducing them to cigars, and you're talking about cigars has a great influence on that as well.
Thank you. And speaking of women, I got one question that I've been wanting to ask Daniel for the longest time. That cigar that Bill Clinton used back in those days, you know, was that your cigar?
You know, the White House asked me not to talk about that.
Okay, so it's confidential. It's classified.
But it's funny you mentioned that. Really, very funny, because I did an event in London in June of last year, and it was at the Davidoff Cigar Lounge in London, which is fantastic. We had 40 people smoking the gold cigar. They each paid £200 to come to the event. We drank Balvenie whiskey. It was an amazing event. The next day, Davidoff called me, and they said, you know who came in to the hotel? I says, who? Well, President Clinton. And I says, and? Well, we sent up to his suite some cigars for him to purchase. And we just happened to send a golden cigar up along with a selection of great Cuban cigars. And guess what Bill Clinton bought?
What he bought?
The gold cigar.
The gold cigar, he bought it.
He bought it. Cool. So, you know, there's definitely a link to the
great
president.
There's a connection there. There's a connection there. Anyways,
One more joke.
One more joke.
What's your latest?
My latest? Damn, you got handcuffed. Wow.
I broke away.
Really?
Every day I'm breaking away.
I
escaped.
That's new.
Look at that. A friend of mine makes this. It's really cool. If I can only get it off. But the idea is to leave it on.
Oh, wow. This is cool, man. This is cool.
All made in sterling silver. And everybody asks me, where's the other handcuff?
This is so cool. This is cool. You know? Wow. I care with this also because I'm Hispanic, to help the police, you know?
give them a head start.
Anyway, here's a joke to go. Scarface fan. Scarface is going to be released one more time. Only this time in 3D. Imagine, a movie about cocaine in 3D. Well, hell, bring your spoon. Give me that. Anyway, I gotta get going because I have another job in July. But this is so great. Thank you, Daniel, for having me. Thank you.
It is coated in gold. 24 carats of the finest Florentine gold foil. The DM2 gold torpedo, there's nothing else like it. Its appearance is elegant and mysterious. The man behind this masterpiece, Daniel Marshall. Marshall is taking a special trip from California to Berlin for a cigar fair at one of the best-known cigar traders in town. In his suitcase lies a true object of desire, a golden cigar. The 12 best cigar and accessory manufacturers are meeting for an exclusive tobacco product show. There are only specialists here. Today, everything is about the enjoyment and the cult of the cigar. The Californian is attracting a lot of attention. There's a lot of interest in his golden cigar and many different opinions.
Eine Rakete aus Schokolade.
A rocket made of chocolate and indulgence.
Mit Genuss doch verbunden.
It looks great, of course. But for me, however, I find it's more of a lifestyle product than a tobacco product. It appeals to me on an aesthetic level, but not really as something to be actively enjoyed. The idea of gilding a cigar came to Daniel Marshall when he received an order to develop a humidor for the movie Scarface in 2011. It was so luxurious that he felt it deserved a cigar that was just as unique.
I had no idea that I'd ever be smoking a cigar covered in gold, but now that I am, it's tremendous because it's really celebrating a golden moment.
In order to enjoy it, cigar lovers will have to dig deep. Cigars gilded in 24 karat gold cost $200 each. However, a good cigar is not only recognized by its gold. It's quite an art to find the perfect mixture of tobacco. Three different types of tobacco from Nicaragua are used for Marshall's exclusive masterpieces. An additional feature of its quality is the hand production. Only the best master rollers have command over the correct rotation technique.
The pressure that what she's doing applying right now to the cigars with each one of her fingers is critical, because if it's too tight, that becomes a cigar that's not smokable. So it takes too much. You have to be a vacuum cleaner to smoke the cigar. So if her pressure is too light, then there'll be too much space in between the tobacco leaves, and it will burn unevenly, or it will just it will fall apart.
One can tell a hand-rolled cigar by its irregularity and its closed cigar head. Its external coat should be even, a sign that much attention has been paid to detail. But what would a cigar be without the right accessories? From the cigar cutter to the high-quality humidor, the latter is a must for the proper storage of these sensitive tobacco products.
The most important point is that they realize that they need a humidor. That's why it's very important to have the idea that the cigar is living. So you want to keep it between 65% humidity, no more than 72% humidity.
Daniel's personal success story began at the beginning of the 80s with such a wooden box. In order to make his dream of owning a sailboat come true, he borrowed $15,000 from his then-girlfriend's grandfather. The search for a suitable thank you led to the Californian's ticket into the humidor business.
So why not make him something that he loves, something for his cigars? Knew nothing about cigars. So I made him a little case in the wood I was building my boat. Held three cigars with a little plate on the bottom. To Papa Joe, love Danny. Thank you for believing in me. 1981.
The former surfer is now a successful businessman. His interpretation of luxury has practically made him a celebrity among cigar lovers. Hollywood stars such as Will Smith and Al Pacino are among his regular clientele. And close friendships have also developed through the cigar business, for example with Arnold Schwarzenegger and Ralph Möller. Caroline Beil has arranged to meet Daniel Marshall and try his golden cigar. In order to learn to smoke these properly, he teaches her some important rules which cigar smokers should follow. Then our host is finally able to savor some golden enjoyment.
Daniel, I just saw the sign. To smoke is human, to smoke a cigar is divine. What is so divine about smoking a cigar?
Well, that is certainly something that words cannot express better than the experience of smoking a cigar.
How does a professional cigar smoker smell a cigar?
Certain people smell the wrapper, but the way to really smell is through the foot of the cigar. Mm-hmm. The masters and the geniuses can actually tell you where the tobacco is from, mm-hmm, and which factory produced it.
It does smell sweet. Mm-hmm. So is there something like chocolate or?
Well, that's the blend. Daniel Marshall cigar is chocolate and espresso and creaminess. I want it to taste like a cappuccino.
Cigar aficionados also have a certain procedure for lighting a cigar. After cutting off the tip, the cigar foot is lit while continuously being spun. This allows the cigar to burn especially evenly. The first puff should only be taken after this step. Connoisseurs do not light the cigar while it is in their mouth.
It's very mellow. It's very almost sweet. Nice. But you don't inhale.
Inhaling is a word I don't even know what it means. Because as I've always said, we don't even smoke cigars. We taste cigars. For the first kiss, for the first moment, it has to be a good experience. And the good experience would be if you do not inhale, like you might a cigarette.
In order to underscore the experience, it's nice to combine it with a drink.
So now that I have this very beautiful taste in my mouth, I have to say, I didn't expect that, so, really. What would be the perfect drink? Water, whiskey, red wine?
My favorite drink would be whiskey. The taste starts out very smooth and rich and evolves. I think that whiskey is made exactly the same way as cigars. So I like to say that we taste history with a cigar and we taste history with whiskey.
Daniel, what makes the cigar so special for you? Is it the gold? Is it the taste? Is it the luxury itself? What would you say?
I think it's a combination of the things you said. The look is beautiful. I've always loved gold. The taste is spectacular. But more than anything, what that gold cigar now represents to me is the idea that I can share in people's celebration.
As sophisticated and unique as the smoking of a cigar is, in the end, all that is left over is a small pile of ash. Nevertheless, even these remains are valuable. The gold of every DM cigar is worth $70, a unique luxury which in the end goes up in smoke.
Nice. I'm sitting here with my man Daniel Marshall, and right now we're smoking the Daniel Marshall 24 karat torpedo, the only 24 karat gold cigar. This is real gold that we're smoking. Yeah. Why don't you give him a little bit more information about it, Daniel?
Hey, this is definitely a victory cigar. It's a cigar we can use to celebrate life's moments, our golden moments in life, and I describe the feeling similar to opening up the finest bottle of wine, the greatest whiskey of the world, and sharing it with close friends.
Right. Me and my partner British, we was in Las Vegas, and he actually pulled your cigar out.
No.
Yes, and I'm not sure if you're familiar with Swiss Beats. It's Alicia Keys' husband. He went. Yes, he seen the cigar, wanted to take the cigar with him, and inquired for about 15 to 20 minutes what kind of cigar it is. And there was a whole bunch of other people that came around and was like, where can we get this cigar from? If people want to get the cigar, where could they get it from?
Well, they contact us and we can refer them to the dealer in their area, and they're very special. They're only in the best tobacco shops all around the world right now. And so they can contact us at danielmarshall.com. And we also have a website called thegoldencigar.com.
You understand? Like, what people don't realize, and the question I had for Daniel when I first met him was, is it okay to smoke gold? And he broke that down to me. Like, yeah. is it safe health-wise to smoke gold? And explain to them how that goes also.
Well, it's interesting because gold is the only element, the only metal that you can ingest as much as you want. That's why there's no limit to gold. Even if you did eat the gold, it has zero toxicity, zero effect on the body. So it's a very interesting material. That's why they use it in people's teeth and to use fillings and whatnot. And the other interesting thing that makes this cigar also very special is it leaves a golden ash to help you celebrate your golden moment.
You heard that golden ash to celebrate that golden moment. I like that. And what smooth do.
There's something really magic about a cigar. And whether you smoke cigars or don't smoke cigars, if you give a cigar to somebody, it has makes a tremendous impact. It makes a tremendous gift, and you immediately can develop a rapport with somebody. And if you're walking with somebody on the street and they're smoking a cigar, you can immediately go over and say, "Hey, what are you smoking?" And before you know it, this has happened all over the world with me. I can become friends with people from all walks of life, any country, any background, and we can become best friends like that.
Well, so, let me tell you something, and I told you a minute ago, as soon as British pulled this cigar out, he got about 30 new friends that he's never met. As soon as he pulled out, they surrounded him and asked, "Where'd you get the cigar from? Where can I get it from?" They didn't even care about the price. The presentation alone is tremendous. So,
anytime, and when you have your next celebration, your next victory party, any reason at all, well, I think that,
Well, let me tell you something, Daniel. I have a victory party about every other day. So, basically, we'll be smoking these tonight, or not tonight, Wednesday, definitely, because victory party's going about 3 times a week because I stay winning. So, super. Absolutely.
We're victorious. And so, hopefully, this cigar everyone can use and enjoy and savor and enjoy the modern day campfire with friends and help remember their special moment. And as I say, we don't really smoke cigars, we taste cigars. And this is definitely one to taste and enjoy.
Absolutely. Thanks again.
Thank you, Ken.
No, thank you.